Hi guys. So, I've been thinking about a new coin that I would like to start. And I'd like to have your feedback. I'm looking for people to, if they are interested, to join. And but it has certain ideas that you might or might not agree with. So I'd love to hear what you think about it. I think a coin can be started like a company. I don't see a difference. That means that a company is always someone that starts it, and he owns the company in full, and then he looks for people that add value, and he gives them, depending on what they offer, a piece of the company. It's very important that good deals are made, good partnerships are found, but the process is that one person starts, or two, a small amount of people start and work for it, create value, and then they issue more shares to those that also want to add value. And yeah, so I want to do it like that. That means the coin, the currency, starts very centralized, but as it becomes bigger, it becomes more decentralized as more and more people join, add value, and become a coin holder. I also like very much that the coin holders have the same power as a shareholder in a company. That means he really owns it, and he really has the power to decide via majority vote anything about the company. In companies, the way it works is that the shareholders only select the leaders and how much they get paid, like the CEO, the CFO, or they select the board members, and the board members select the leaders. But you could actually make it much more active, that that shareholders are really like not just choosing someone to do it for them. You could really make it more decentralized, that they actually are the leader and are making decisions that normally the CEO makes, like all the people that get hired and all the projects that are started. But of course, it's very important that a shared vision is there. So yeah, I don't know exactly how that will work, but that's the idea, the direction I want to go. And then I really would like to focus on just user adoption, but end-user adoption. So the goal is to get to create a currency that's used a lot more than Bitcoin is used. And so the focus is not to build decentralized applications, but just to build a currency that is easy to use, to send and receive transactions, but also to store the money, because with Bitcoin this is still way too complex for the common man, and that's the only goal. And in order to get that adoption, of course it's crucial how user friendly these things are to use, and also you really need to motivate people to start to use your currency. That's the problem with Bitcoin. People are not stupid. They know, okay, if I start a company, if I start accepting Bitcoin, I'm helping Bitcoin to create more value for Bitcoin, but what's my benefit? What's my profit? And I think that's really lacking with the current models. You really need to reward people that bring value to your currency, and that's not only people that program the currency or that market the currency. It's also people that really that adopt the currency, that help the currency get adopted, and of course business owners and certain users that do a lot of evangelizing. They should also get paid. And how do you pay all these people? Well, you have to be very careful that you don't pay people that only created value short term, and long term they leave again, because then you lost coins. Of course, you pay them by issuing new coins. So that's the model here. You continue to issue new coins, but you always make sure that for every issuance given to some people or some company or some investor, you give them less new coins than the value you get in return. And to do that process well, I think it's very good to do that in a more decentralized way, so that different people can be busy studying these things. Because if just one person does it, it's a good start. You have to start that way, but over time it's probably gonna work much better if you do it more decentralized. And I also think it's very important to start when you want to have your currency be adopted, to really start on very small segment in the market. For example, you could start in the gaming market. A lot of games have currencies in them. What you could really try is to focus on having a certain game to start using your currency. Of course, these game makers won't do that for free. You have to pay them. So you have to give them newly issued currency in exchange for adopting the currency. And you have to like find the right balance. You shouldn't be giving them more than the amount of value they add. And then you can, like, if you seek in one game, it will be easier to find other games that also do the same. And that's how you become a... And then if you do that job really well, then some games after a while will actually really also want your currency, because it will be vital to attract players, because the currency already has a lot of players that know it. And so if they use your currency instead of their own game currency, then they will likely have more chance to success. And at that point, you don't need to pay these game makers anymore with newly issued currency, because you have the network effect going, and that's when you really start to profit. But to get that network effect going, you really have to focus on a small market segment, and only when you dominate there, you can go to another market segment. So the programming of the interface of the currency, as well as the marketing, is fully focused on realizing this goal. And I think that's a much better approach than how cryptocurrencies do it. It's like, oh look, we created something great, now people, the door is open, you can come and start adapting our currency. Of course, with Bitcoin, a lot of people evangelize, but the problem is, you really have to get this going. The problem is, okay, some merchants adopt it, but those that adopt it, they only adopt it because they want more business, but not many Bitcoiners spend their Bitcoin, so they start adopting Bitcoin, and not many people buy with Bitcoin, so they cancel it after a while. It's a problem. I think these are the big ideas that I'm playing with. And so I'm not sure an ICO is necessary, because I certainly wouldn't be wanting to sell 100% of my coins from day one. Why would I do that? It's like you start a company, you sell 100% of your shares to the highest bidder on day one. Well, that makes no sense to me. And so that's why I really think there is no difference between a currency and a stock. And I could be totally wrong in that. We will see. But I think that's the case. And I see that projects like Dash are actually successful they implemented decentralized organization more, and so people can vote on who gets how much money, and it's also created with newly issued coins. I paid everything with newly issued coins. That's very good, but But it's thanks to the starters, the founders, having a lot of currency that they have a lot of control over the what's the results of the votes. Eh? And so they like to sell it as decentralized, but the thing is, as with a company, you would never get a startup off the ground if you have 10 people or 100 people deciding what to do. Eh? Yeah, a company is successful because of a strong vision of the founder, and that's very important. If he does things right, the people that will enter the organization will have a shared vision and an example, and that's. But they need to like come in slowly, and the selection process is very important there, and so. So yeah, it's a very different way of looking at a currency and launching a currency. But it also comes with the reality of the world we're living in. We're not living in a world anymore where cryptocurrency are not sure if it's legal or not. It has become legal thanks to Bitcoin. And the way the politicians have responded, they have allowed it to happen and they haven't banned it. And as long as they didn't, a cryptocurrency needs not be from the start decentralized. Of course, it has never been. Bitcoin was also very centralized in the start. You always have the founders that have a lot of currency at the start, and then it becomes more decentralized. So, but what's important, I think, is that it does become more decentralized over time. Just like a company, have more and more shareholders. And that's good and not good. It's good for the stability of the company because decisions, like there is much less change. And because people, like, it's very hard to change, to convince a lot of people to do something differently. They will only do that if there is enough pain. So if there is failure, then they will be convinced to change. But otherwise, not so. As a company grows bigger, they will just do the same as they did before. As long as they are successful, and that's how you get very stable companies like General Electric or IBM or Microsoft. They are very big, and even though you don't have much potential to make money if you invest in that, it will go up with the inflation. You won't lose your money, and it's pretty stable. It happens rarely that a big company like that goes from big to broke in a short matter of time. It does happen, but you can study these things and make sure you don't have one of those. And I think we will have in the future a world like that too with currencies. You will have some big currencies, and because you have a lot of coin holders, not much has changed, as with Bitcoin already is the case. But the problem with Bitcoin is that actually over time it becomes more centralized due to a mistake in the design. The proof of work system makes that a few miners actually decide whether changes are implemented in Bitcoin or not, and that creates big wars. There are all other problems too with Bitcoin, that is that the developers that work on it are paid by a outside company, and so also don't work for the interest of the coin holder. So of course I don't want anything like that. I really do believe proof of stake, as NXT started with, is a much better foundation to get a more decentralized currency, but also a much cheaper currency to manage. You need to be protected against 51% attacks, and you need to validate transactions, and that needs to be done as securely as possible, but also as cheaply as possible. Bitcoin achieves that security, but the security is not very high. It's quite easy and cheap compared to the value of Bitcoin to achieve that 51% of the validation power. You only need to bribe or threaten a few people or hack a few people to have that. And so that's not a good design, and doesn't give a lot of security to invest a lot of money in that. So you will have that a lot better with the proof of stake foundation. But of course not at the start, because it will still be very centralized. But over time, if it succeeds to grow a lot, you will have a much more security that you can actually put in a lot of money, and that it's pretty stable. It's probably always be better, like even with big companies today, to have some kind of index fund where you have a lot of big companies in, that will give a lot more security, but also a lot less potential to go up. But I think we can achieve the same with currencies. I'm looking for programmers, a great programmer, a great interface designer, and a great marketeer. And I'm not planning to I'm planning to pay them myself, and work a couple of months on something, to get something out of the door quick and simple. I don't want to over-engineer anything. I've learned that you have to work in small iterations and get something out as quickly as possible with as little investment as possible, and try to get it rolling with the end user, and really work with feedback constantly, to design in the right direction and to make sure you have growth in adoption constantly. So please contact me if you're interested. Bye.